Hello, this is Thomas from Hotkey404, and in this video I'll show you how to turn this into fully functional Freepbx-based GSM gateway. Okay, so here's the list of stuff that we are going to use. We will use power supply with 3 amps and USB Type-C, Ethernet patch cord, microSD card, some microSD USB adapter, a compatible 3G modem from Huawei, HDMI cable, micro HDMI adapter. We could use the regular display, but I'm going to capture the video with HDMI video grabber with full HD. And of course, our favorite Raspberry Pi 4 with 4 GB of RAM. First, we will prepare our microSD card, so let's put it into a USB adapter, connect to our computer, and to upload the operating system, we will use Raspberry Pi Imager. As you can see, this program allows you to install various operating systems. We will choose custom previously downloaded file with RasPBX, choose our SD card, and just write the system to the card. And before using Raspberry Pi Imager, you might want to use SD formatter, which will format the card and at the same time remove all hidden partitions from the card, if any exist. Now, since the system has been loaded onto the card, we can remove it from the computer, mount into Raspberry, connect our USB modem, connect HDMI using an adapter, and instead of a regular display, we will use an HDMI grabber, then connect the equipment to the network, and finally connect to the power supply. We can see that the system has booted up nicely. In the meantime, I connected the keyboard to check the IP address and switched to the connection via SSH, but this is not a requirement. So as we can see, our system is loaded, so we can log in with the data that is user root and password Raspberry. To check the IP address, we will do IPA. Now let's enter the displayed address into the SSH client and log in once again with the same data, root and Raspberry. And we are greeted with a beautiful list of additional commands that we can execute on our RasPBX system. Let's start with updating the software using RasPBX upgrade. We are going to speed this up a little bit, and in the meantime, it is worth mentioning that the command that is not listed, raspconfig, allows you to change some additional settings like network settings and, for example, extending your SD card to its actual size. As you can see, it takes a while, but after the update is finished, we can add support for the USB modem with the command install-dongle. And now we will be asked about a few things. We will start with SIM card number. We will leave empty to disable both SMS redirects to email or SMS. We will install a simple web page for sending SMS, and we will use a password that I strongly discourage using. From what we can see on the screen, we can see that our Asterisk and FreePBX are almost ready. So after it finishes, we will simply reboot our Raspberry. Now we are almost done. To check if our device is properly recognized, we will use ls-l and then /dev/tty Asterisk, and you will see 3 USB devices. If we have that, we can enter asterisk CLI with asterisk-r, and if we enter dongle show device state and our dongle 0, we will see that device is connected and its state is free, so it's waiting for connections. Now we can send a test message, so we will use dongle SMS, our device dongle 0, then receiving number, and then our message. And after sending this, you should see a notification that the message was sent successfully. At this stage, we can complete the Freepbx installation via web browser, or we can simply send an SMS via simple web panel. As always, we haven't covered all of RasPBX capabilities here. I recommend visiting official manufacturer's website, link in the description. There you will find a lot of documentation and description of systems capabilities. As usual, I recommend also visiting our website if you want to go step by step what we've done today. So good luck in your installation, and see you in the next one.